Now, let's get to another high-performing individual, the Australian singer-songwriter sensation. Dami Im has just released her latest EP, Live Sessions, showcasing the power of her live performances.
The X Factor winner and Eurovision star sat down with Georgie to talk about the EP and treated News Breakfast to her new song, Dreamer.
So, Dami, firstly, welcome to News Breakfast. Thanks for taking the time to join us.
Thank you for having me here.
What's been happening for you? What's been going on?
I've been touring Australia and writing my own songs, recording, and then my new live EP is just come out. So, been busy.
Talk us through the new EP, because it is aptly named Live Sessions. All of these songs were recorded live on your tour. What's the difference then for you? Why did you decide to go that particular path? Is there a difference when you're recording or the sound of it for you?
I think there's just like this extra special energy when I'm performing live, and I've been having such a great time touring the last couple of years, and I decided, why don't I, you know, record some of these special moments so I can share it with more people and kind of keep the moments forever. And yeah, it's kind of a celebration of the tours that I've done.
What does a live audience bring to your performance? What does it add for you when you are on the road?
I think, you know, when I record in a studio, it's special, but it's kind of, it's just me and the engineer and we're just doing that. But when there's a whole audience, you get a response straight away. So it gives me that energy. And, you know, even if I tried to do that without the audience, I can't emulate that, you know, that special buzz that gives me when I'm performing, and the band as well, of course.
Stranger to live performances. Firstly, I mean, in terms of Australian audiences getting to know you on The X Factor, but then international audiences getting to see you perform live on Eurovision. Did your life change after Sweden a couple of years ago at Eurovision?
My life changed. Well, yes, it's changed. Just the most special experience. I can never stop talking about it. It was like being in the Olympics, being on the biggest stage in the world, and it was such a buzz. But also it made me realize that I really, really love performing, and I love making my music and sharing it with people. So I think I'd started to take more control and take it a lot more seriously in a way.
And some new talent, well, not new, they are recognizable faces, but someone else will get that chance at Eurovision next year. It's a bit of a different format where Australia will decide who gets to go forward and compete. Now, you know what that is like. Are you a fan of this new system? Do you think it's going to work?
I think it's really great that they're doing this new thing where, you know, Australia gets a say and we get to decide which one's going to go. And there's some, you know, really great acts going in for it. So personally, I'm so intrigued to see who we're going to send in the end. Mm. And yeah, it's different, but I think it's pretty exciting.
Are you protective of your second placing? Do you obviously wishing people well, but are you competitive and just eyeing if anyone else can knock you off that second
I'm
place?
I'm so competitive. If someone's going to do well, I'll go and No, I'm kidding. I'm wishing them very well, but also just, yeah, I'm watching.
Just a close eye. Just a close eye.
Yes.
I love that.
I'm a dreamer. A believer. I know what I want.
So with the new album, a new song as well, Dreamer, what's behind that? Because I am fascinated by the first line.
So I wrote Dreamer when I was touring, and it was after Eurovision, so I was very serious. And, you know, one day I was sort of feeling like everybody was telling me what to do and how I should pose in my photos. Why don't you smile? Why aren't you smiling? And, I was like, I'm sick of this, you know. I want to make my own decisions with my music and with my life and everything. So I started writing with that line, I want to stop smiling on my Instagram, because that was the first thing that came up in my mind. And the rest sort of just flowed through. And I sang that for the first time in one of the live shows. And I love this song. It's really personal.
Well, what's it like when audiences then, because it is live, you get that immediate feedback. So when you are performing something new for the first time, What's that like? Are you watching everyone's reactions?
I was so nervous because no one's heard it before. So I said, okay, I'm going to sing this song. If you don't like it, we'll just pretend it never happened. And it was a really magical feeling because I kind of really put my heart on my sleeve. And in that song, I just revealed my very honest, raw emotions. And I could feel the audience kind of coming with me. And I thought, wow, that's so special. So I decided not to hide it. And I guess it gave me the courage to just share it. It was the best feeling.
Well, it's an authentic song, an authentic sound as well. Dami, thank you for joining us. And I think we're going to get a little bit of a sneak peek and listen to Dreamer as well now, so everyone can enjoy it. But Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you so much for having me.
Wanna stop smiling on my Instagram, say what I want to, 'cause I can. Sick of feeling like a cute little bird stuck in a cage on display, with only one song to sing every night and day. I'm not a puppet who moves with your head, and I'm not that woman who begs for command. I'll never settle for what's second best. I know what I want. I'm searching for ways to describe the rivers of thoughts in my mind. Not even a book full of words could say what's inside. I'm not that stupid, don't need your advice. And I have a vision, and I know the price.
I do. I feel like I want to applaud. That was awesome.
Well done, Dami Im. Great chat there with Georgie Tunney.